Simón.
After years of resisting Kublai Khan's siege, Fan Cheng and Shang Yang still refused to submit to Mongol rule. To take the cities, Kublai Khan would harness the full power of his empire by enlisting an ally from the Ilkhanate of Persia. Ismail, a siege expert, would lead the Mongol army in the construction of the Huihui Pao, an immensely powerful counterweight trebuchet. This new trebuchet, once constructed, could hurl boulders greater in size than any weapon before it. During the years-long siege, Kublai Khan had established lucrative trade routes with Chinese market towns who swore loyalty to him. Although these trade partners were vulnerable to Song attacks, they could deliver valuable resources to fund Ismail's efforts. The Mongol commercial network could supply Ismail in stone so long as he had enough traders on the road.
Я тут
With the counterweight trebuchet constructed, the Mongols could mount their assault on the twin cities. As Ismail's trebuchet had a far greater range than those of the Song defenders, the Mongols could attack from a safe distance. Drawn to the bombardment from the trebuchet, the Song soldiers left gaps elsewhere in their defense, which the Mongols could exploit.
Thank you. Шахи хусмой. Ушаа нэрч
праваачтай.
Хурагшаа.
Орд алтан ургас. Бэдэг.
Чи юу хүс мөй?
Ча.
Ушаа дэган карстаа уусан. Гүтэд харваачтай.
Үндэ хөсөн гон кибин.
Уха.
Айба. 是时候散散步了
Ойфлаатар, тайд хүчин зүдэгсүү. Хүчин зүд, тайд хүчин зүдэгсүү.
With the bridge rebuilt, the doors to Fancheng were wide open.
Oh.
The Mongols swept into Fancheng, striking down any Song warriors in their path.
Ya, Oh,
After years of holding out against the Mongols, the first of the twin cities finally fell to Kublai Khan's army. All that now stood between Kublai Khan and the throne of China was the final stronghold of the Song, the city of Shangyang. Using the immense range of the great trebuchet, Ismail aimed to lay waste to Shangyang's great keep. Ismail's counterweight trebuchet proved its might, shaking the earth and shattering the spirits of the Song. The great keep of Shangyang had fallen. With Shangyang's gate undefended, the Mongols could now repair the connecting bridge to the Song stronghold. With the city in disarray, the Mongols were free to tear down the imperial palace. Thank you. Mongol warriors flooded the streets of Shangyang as the Song defenders rose to make a desperate last stand. Shangyang, the great bastion of the Song dynasty, had fallen. Kublai Khan had finished what his grandfather, Genghis Khan had started. And now, he could establish his own great dynasty and sit on the throne of all China.